Wait a minute! You want me to stay here? No, I'm going with you!
No, it's too dangerous.
Why? I've been in many dangerous situations. This isn't the first time!
I said no! We can't take you. Please understand.
No, I want to go! We've been fighting together all this time! And suddenly you're telling me not to go? I just don't get it!
This isn't like any other fight. It's a battle for the wisdom created by God. It's life or death. Whoever controls it becomes the true dominator of the world. It's obvious the ministry will bring the strongest possible troops. There's no guarantee you'll come back alive.
That's exactly why I want to go.
You don't have the slightest idea.
What don't I understand?
If the enemy were only just the ministry or mechanical weapons, it would be okay. But most of the enemies will be made up of were once humans. Humans just like you and I. I saw them at those facilities. Gears that were made out of humans. They were the same as Hammer. Could you now destroy them knowing after this? In order to save ourselves, can you truly say that you could kill those who were once our friends? So, do you still want to go now?
Well...
You can't even kill one person. Your presence would be a burden during the fight. You just get in the way. Hey, Faye. Don't you think you went a little too far there?
We cannot blame her. At least we should understand her feelings.
I know how Ellie feels. I know she wouldn't have listened to me if I just said, "You're not coming." Seeing as how she worked together was such a long time ago. That's why I had to explain it to her like that. The people gathered in Nissan need Ellie. She's gotta realize how much people are depending on her. I can't put her in a dangerous situation.
But the way you said it was a little harsh.
You don't have to be so cold. She was crying, you know?
But...
I am sure she realizes that.
I agree. Maybe you're the one who doesn't understand. Me? I don't understand?
A lady's heart?
She wants you to go, to be with you, Faye. Until the end.
Yeah!
If I were you, I hold her tight and say, "Let's go together." Just like that.
Really?
No. I mean, crap. Young master, don't overdo yourself now. Shut up, Mason.
Anyhow, why don't you go ask her to come with you? Whether she'll go or not, you should express your feelings in words. If you really care about her, you have to go tell her.
Express your feelings, right?
I didn't mean...
Too late now. Everyone knows it.
You are not being true to yourself, are you?
I agree. Say it straight out. Go ahead, go chase after her. What are you waiting for?
Sorry about what just happened. Forgive me. But I want to explain. Now, for the first time, people on both Earth and Solaris are becoming one. But then, not all of them are strong like the crew of the ship, or the people in Shivat. Even we almost lose sight of our future at times, so you can imagine what regular people go through. That's why people need someone like you to depend on, as a light to guide us. You freed the hearts of the people that have been used as tools by that ministry for hundreds of years. Ellie, it was you! And now your body doesn't just belong to you alone anymore. That's why I can't let you be in any danger. And that's why I don't want you to fight anymore.
It's funny, isn't it?
Huh?
We used to be enemies, but now we're together like this. In the beginning, I think I saw myself in you. We seemed to overlap, you being in a similar situation as I was in. When I was with you, I didn't feel alone or apprehensive. That's why I thought I liked you. But it wasn't that. I simply didn't have the courage to look at my true self. I turned to you to run away from it all. I mistook that for love. But it's different now. I can face my own problems. I am me, and you are you. It has all become clear to me now. I also learned that I really do need you. It's not because I need you as a sanctuary for my problems. I need you because I truly love you.
Ellie.
I know what you're saying, Faye. I know why you're so concerned for my safety. But, you know, I'm scared. I fear we may never see each other again. I just have this feeling.
Don't worry, I won't die.
No, it's not that. It's something completely different. It's as if I'm being torn apart by something I can't resist, that I'm no longer me. Even if you come back safely, it just feels so uneasy. That is why I need to go with you. I can't bear to be away from you.
I feel the same way, ever since that time I met you in the forest. I think it's the same feeling that you've been having. I was also running to you. But I have to solve my own problems. I can't throw my problems onto you. There's another me. Id is within me. I fear that at any moment Id may awaken within me. You're the only one that has been able to keep me from giving in to Id. It was because you were always by my side that I was able to keep from losing myself. I promise you that I will return. So, that is, Ellie, I want you to be my reason to return, to be my home that I can return to. Ellie, if you will wait for me to come back, even if we are in totally different places, as long as you will stay by my side, I know I'll be able to do anything.
Oh, Faye. Are you going now?
Yeah. Sorry, did I wake you?
It's okay. I've been awake all along.
All along?
I was watching over you while you slept, and before I realized it. It was morning.
Well, I'm off.
All right, then. Do be careful.
Yeah, I will. Oh, could you hold on to this for me?
What is this? Is this a pendant?
I don't know whose it is. It seems it was on me when I was brought into Mahanon. It may be mine, or it could be.
It could be...
Oh, nothing. Will you just hold on to it for me?
All right, I'll hold on to it for you.
Thanks. Well, I guess it's goodbye.
Oh, Faye?
Yeah?
Thank you.
Sure.
Ellie, are you okay about this? Don't you want to be with him?
Yes, but it's because I believe in him. Just being close to a person is not in itself an indication of love, is it?
But men are selfish. When something big happens, they say, "It's too dangerous, you can't come." They treat women like we are weaklings. Although, it is true I can't help Barton friends much anymore.
That's not true. Everyone wants someone special waiting for them. Someone who will protect a place they can return to. If you don't have that peace of mind, then you would not be able to get anything done. Men try to tough it out as much as they can, and then some. They're cute the way they do that, aren't they?
Yeah, you're right.
Anyway, we have things we have to do too now. And while we do them, let's pray that everyone comes back safely.
To God?
No. To your own innermost feelings that everyone believes in. What's wrong?
I knew it. Yes, that must be it.
What?
Ellie, it's like everyone says. You must be a reincarnation of Sophia. You have no way of knowing the Nissan 6 teachings, but what you say... Well, it's exactly the same as what Sophia always said.
Yes, that might be it. The first time I visited here, I had the most amazing feeling. Familiar. Sad. Like I had visited here many times in my dreams. I know where each room is and what's in them. I just know I must have been here in the distant past. Before, if you had spoken of this, I'd have brushed it off with a laugh. But now... Now I can more or less believe it. The things I couldn't do then, I'm probably trying to do now.
Things you couldn't do?
Yes. Things I couldn't do.
Driving back the Solarian interceptor forces, we took to the floating continent, Mahanon. It was the central hull of a colossal spacecraft with a diameter of at least 40 kelts. Judging from the condition of the hull, we estimated the ship was at least thousands of years old. It was determined by examining the inside of the wreckage that some kind of accident occurred on the ship about 10,000 years ago, which forced it to crash onto our planet. Alien beings that came to our planet from a far-off galaxy, aeons ago. Could it possibly have been that our progenitors were the passengers of the ship and it crash-landed here on this planet? Seeking God in his divine wisdom, Raziel's tree, which, it is said, lie here in Mahanon, we proceeded further. In the depths, we saw an alien body. It was partially rotted and petrified. A giant, grotesque being. It gave off an inexplicable air of intimidation. Perhaps it was more than a gut reaction. Perhaps it was the fear of the absolute that came from the very depths of our inherited instincts.
Doc, what do we do? It keeps killing us. Faye, pay attention. Whenever we take damage, it takes damage.
System.
When it's weakened, new system in. That should defeat it.
Commencing first attack.
God damn it, Faye, you're always so flashy. Man, I wish I could be that cool. Oh look, it's dead. Yay. Wish I did something useful.
You took the killing blow for us. God damn it, Satan.
That was the ultimate power? The partially rotted thing eventually self-disintegrated. We proceeded even further. We came to an enormous cavern that was big enough to swallow the whole capital of Abbey. In its center were two gently glowing objects. It was the source of divine wisdom. It was Raziel's tree.
And the cavern itself was a giant computer called Raziel. The wisdom of God, hidden within Raziel. We found the unthinkable when we accessed its data. A large, unmanned strategic weapon and its battalion of terminal interface weapons traveling from star system to star system, and a gargantuan mothership used to carry them. The creation of the Malak Angels, God's army to reign over the vast universe with, and the construction of the Divine Ark. These weapons were called Yabe, the Interplanetary Invasion Weapon System. What the Gazil Ministry was looking for was right here. According to the data, the giant rotting organism we first defeated was in fact the nucleus of the system. We were on the verge of accessing the data for the object called Zoe. The control central circuit and power source controlling the entire system, from weapons to the mothership. When suddenly, he appeared. Ah, the hidden data from Raziel's tree. Move away from there. This matter is far too weighty for the likes of you.
We must protect it with our lives. We can't let them have the Raziel data. You handle them. I will try and extract as much data as I am able to. If anything goes wrong, I will destroy the place. Graf. I guess I have no choice.
System hidden. Engaged.
My fight isn't with you, it's with him. Get out of here. This is pathetic.
Oh, god damn it! I hate when this happens. I didn't even get to hit him! Son of a bitch!
Yay,
kick his ass. I am totally rooting you from over here, even though I'm incapacitated. I can't do anything. This really sucks.
Your attacks, they are worthless.
God damn it, he's kicking your ass. Don't give in, evil Fae thingy.
Commencing second attack.
Have you learned nothing?
Oh, god damn it!
So weak.
Really, this sucks. You suck, Graf!
I guess that's all you can take for now. Are you frustrated? But that is only natural. After all, you are imperfect.
Imperfect?
Yes, you are lacking now. The absence of wrath is an impediment to you utilizing your true strength.
Wrath?
The drive to massacre and annihilate. The compulsion to destroy your opponent. Such wrath is power for your soul. By eliminating your foe, you attain your first sublimation of that drive. It is this very sublimation that draws up the hidden powers within oneself. But clinging to reason, suppressing your wrath and desire, makes releasing your true power a dream within a dream for you. You already know. know this. When wrath appeared in your heart, the machine responded. Did it not? What drove such power from your machine was truly the drive of your soul. It was your id, the sign of the purpose you've been seeking. The mark of the natural-born assassin.
You're wrong. That's absolutely untrue. I am not id!
The time has come. I'll take your soul and draw its power out to the limit.
Enough.
Huh? What are you stopping me for?
He is bait. If you kill the bait, the precious bird we wish to capture will fly away. You know, a very important bird, needed to fulfill my earnest desire. You understand, don't you, Lacan?
Suit yourself.
We shall crucify them. In the land of Golgotha, to the west of here. Collect all the broken gears.
When Faye and the others had arrived at the deepest part of Mahanon, I was looking after the newly mutated people in Nissan. People mutating, one after the other. Like some eternal nightmare that made me wonder just how long we would have to keep on nursing them.
Are you okay? You haven't had any rest, have you? I can handle things on my own for a while. Why don't you go out for a walk?
Thank you, but I'll be all right. I'd rather keep busy so I don't worry about things too much.
Is that it? Hey! Ellie, what's that?
This?
Can I see it? Just as I thought, it's a pendant of Nissan. But what do you have it, Ellie?
It's Faye's. I'm holding on to it for him. But it feels as if I've always worn it.
When you wear that, you look even more like Sophia.
Really? Flattery won't get you anything, you know. Anyway, we need to hurry up and test the new mutation suppressant assembler on those other people there. We can't afford to have them change any further. Oh no. Something has happened to Faye and the others. Overcome by indescribable fear, I decided to ascend to Shavat, which was stationed in the skies above Nissan. Awaiting me there was a transmission from Krellian. He told me that if I wanted to save Faye and the others, I would have to come to Golgotha. Krellian wanted me. In order to save Faye and my other friends, I departed in the last Omnigear left remaining in Shavat. My previous fear of riding in this machine was surmounted by my desire to rescue the people dear to me.
Are you serious about going it alone?
Krellian told me to come by myself. I can't afford to break the agreement. so please, stay behind and protect everyone here.
But it's a trap.
I know.
Then why?
If I do not go, Faye and them will be executed for sure. Krellian isn't concerned with anyone else but me.
So what makes you think he's going to hold this part of the bargain? Do you have any way of knowing that you'll definitely save your friends by doing this?
No.
Then it's suicide!
It might be. But I've made it this far because of Faye and the others. Because they accepted me as their friend.
If you go away, what about us? What about all the people who've assembled in Nissan that you leave behind? Everyone's dependent on you for the spiritual support.
The people in Nissan will be fine. They can stand on their own feet without any support from me. This is also true for you all, right?
But why do you do so much for him?
I don't know. I guess it's a woman's prerogative to be selfish. Perhaps.
A woman's prerogative?
I'm not a holy woman of any sort. I'm just a regular woman. I get angry, I cry, I laugh. Although at times I can resent others, I also know how to love others. Loving whole masses of people at times, and loving just one person the rest of the time. I am in supreme bliss when I am embraced by the man that I love. Giving what I have to him, and receiving what he gives me, we become one flesh. That is the moment when I am most at peace. It is my prerogative as a woman to simply want to save the man that I love.
Boss.
I'm sorry for saying such selfish things. I'll go and do all that I can do for my friends. So I want you all to do whatever it is you can do for our friends here. Well, I had better get going now.
The Golgotha to rescue the others. However, Krillian has Ellie undergo a little experiment. What will the outcome be? Next, on Xenogears dubbed, Episode 29, A Time Long Forgotten.